So start to put together a strategy where we think more long term. And I'm sure that everything that you've heard from Digvijay about how this is going to look like at scale, everything you've heard from Aman about different products, so I think those things also tell you that there is a conscious choice to think long term. And but at the same point of time, when I say long term, I do not equate it with slow. Long term does not mean slow in any scenario whatsoever. The first virtue, no points for guessing, is student first. Everything that we do has to be student first. Our products have to be student first. Our approach has to be student first. Every single time we speak to a student, it has to be student first. Second value is extreme ownership mindset. I think for those of you who have been in the company for a longer period of time, possibly all of 2019, we used to do these town halls in person. You would have heard from me, and you would have heard that I encourage all of you to think and act like entrepreneurs at all times. In fact, I've used the word entrepreneur professionals, because that brings the best of both the words together. You need to be innovative in the way you think about things, in the way you act, in the way you deal with problems. At the same time, you're very professional with how you deal with those things. So can you be entrepreneur professionals? And when I say that, when I say extreme ownership mindset, when I say entrepreneur professionals, when I say accountability within it, it also means that a lot of people won't be the right fit for us. I feel every single person has the ability to act like a founder, to act like an entrepreneur, to act like an owner, and to operate with that owner's mindset. And I believe the best people in this company, the best 10, 15 people in this company on this call, will all rise up to be CXOs and leadership positions and be country heads and whatnot as we grow further. We are still in a very, very early phase of our journey. The intent and the heart is there to make sure that everybody grows in this company. If you think that your growth path is not clear, if it's not very clearly demonstrated to you, me and Yajar, we'll ensure that we do a 1-hour call with you and you're very, very clear about how you want to move forward from here in the company. Extreme ownership mindset. Third one is a bias for action. And what I mean by that, I spoke about speed. What I mean by that is not overthinking, not over-strategizing, not sitting in a lot of meetings, but thinking about how can you actually take actions very, very fast to be able to get done with the problem. How can you show that bias for action in dealing with a student issue? How can you show that bias of action in dealing with what feature to choose? How can you show that bias of action in dealing with do I need to take this code live overnight? How can I show that bias of action when I'm writing content for a host of universities and this needs to be up there the next morning? So can I show a bias for action in everything that we do? Can I show very fierce execution, not overthink, not over-strategize, not just sit in random meetings, not just do just because we have the option of doing multiple Zoom calls, not just keep doing those things, but also demonstrate very, very active, fierce, speed-first execution. And hence, as it's called out, have a bias, have a very, very active bias for action. So student first, extreme ownership mindset, and a bias for action. Fourth one, a very important one, is supreme work ethic and self-explanatory, of course. It means fairness. It means meritocracy. It means zero politics. No politics will be ever tolerated in the company at any level whatsoever. Be it high up the ranks, be it with somebody who has just joined the company. Extreme honesty. If you don't feel like working on a certain day, please call out your manager and say as much. Don't say that you have fever. Don't say that you're doing something else. If you want to take 3 days out and if you want to work out of Goa, go ahead and do that. You're completely cool with it. You want to go and work out of Kasauli, go ahead and do that. Do that for a month. If you want to come in into office at 1 p.m. and leave at 1 a.m. or leave at 10 p.m., whatsoever, go ahead and do that. But just be extremely honest with how you communicate with your peers, with your people, with your juniors, with your seniors, people you report into. And at the same time, show that honesty with customers as well. When you commit to somebody that you'll be getting back at a certain point of time, you get back to them at a certain point of time, whether you are in servicing, whether you're in biz dev, whether you're somebody who's making these commitments internally, saying that, hey, you know what, XYZ will be done by then, XYZ will be done by tonight, XYZ will be done by tomorrow morning. I commit to executing ABC results by the 1st of September or DEF results by the 31st of October. make sure that you stand yourself to those promises, to those commitments that you have made, and be very, very, I would again use the word fiercely ethical, and show that honesty and transparency in everything that you do. Fifth one is, in my understanding, when I say every day I'm hustling, it means a combination of two things. It's being courageous towards everything that you do. Plus, it's also being very, very optimistic on our worst days. In a startup, you will see more down days as compared to up days. I have spent time where I've kind of been in a bathtub and cried myself to sleep. I have seen days when I've been extremely happy and joyous, and I would have feel that what psychedelic substance have I taken this week. So you will feel those highs and lows through and through your entire journey. But the beauty, and I call this a beauty, or the contentment of building a company, is that there are going to be more bad days than good days. And for those days, you have to be optimistic. And for those tough decisions, which are going to be far more in number as compared to anything else that will happen, you have to be courageous when you're dealing with those things. So combination of you being courageous, plus you being optimistic, and you executing everything with a very hustle-first attitude, that's the next value. Sixth one is over-deliver. And very simple, it means that you always do more than people expect from you. If this is very easily said, very difficult to follow, but I hope I can, and I can think about 10 people right off my head as I say this. There are a couple of people who do that fantastically in this organization, but can we make sure that 90% of the organization is focusing on those things? Can we be a person who is committing to X and doing Y, doing X plus 3 or doing X plus 10? Can we, if I'm working with, say, Digvijay in the application team in Univali, and I said that, and Digvijay expects that, yeah, 10 applications to 40 dega ye banda aaj. And I turn up at 1 a.m. and tell Digvijay, maine 14 kar diye. Digvijay will be delighted, right? Or anything like that. If I'm Akshay, if I'm my namesake Akshay, and I commit to take a code live, I commit to take a particular feature live at 10 a.m., but I do that the previous night, Aman will be extremely happy. And I can break it down to everybody's level. I can break it down to Neha's level. I can break it down to Mehak's level. I can break it down to Samrat's level, how he's managing university, so on and so forth. So try to be that person wherever you are in the org, whether at the top, whether you are somebody who's just starting out, be that person who's doing more than people expect. The last one, again, I started something. You will realize, for those of you who have been here for a while, at least more than 6 months, you will realize that we haven't as much looked externally for those values. All of these values come internally from what the organization has been up till now, right? We've largely looked internally of what our character is, what our DNA already is. And just like student first is something that we've been talking about since first day, our last value is something that we have been doing since the first day of this company, and that is over-communicate. Don't communicate less. Over-communicate. It's okay if the other person gets bored by how you communicate. I personally am a big fan of it, and I think that should be our value till the end of the time. The fact that sometimes people are also communicating things that are not relevant. If somebody is really happy about some success that they've achieved, go on, share that. Number one, student first. Number two, extreme ownership mindset. Number three, bias for action, speed, fierce execution. Number four, supreme work ethic. Number five, every day I'm hustling. Number six, over-deliver, do more than you expect. Number seven, over-communicate. I don't know how many of you follow IPL, I do. A good sports team also takes out people who don't perform on a certain day. If somebody is not performing, they ask them to sit down, even however much they might love them outside work, however much they might love them outside the field. If Ravindra Jadeja is not performing, he will be asked to sit out. If one of my favorite players is IPL, Kishan is not performing, Rohit Sharma will ask him to step out. Or if Fuller is not performing, he'll be asked to step out, even if he might have a great legacy. So just remember those things as well, that just like we are a family, we are also a sports team. Because when we say, oftentimes, I think we measure family. And family sticks by you even when you're not doing shit. Sports team does not. Sports team cares for you. Sports team cares for your success if you're doing shit. So let's just make sure we are a great championship sports team who's going to win a big championship at the end of it, which is taking this company public in 2025, which is ensuring that we're the most trusted company, which is ensuring people talk about us and people sing songs about us, and we're actually able to build a brand and culture which is synonymous with, like I said, my favorite company, Nike, which people can essentially, there's a brand which is so strong where people say that, you know what, I trust this brand and I'll go with the service, whatnot, whatever. So I think the next year, till the time we were at 300 students, every single student, like 10 students in its entirety, I know of a certain, possibly by next year, nobody in the market will, no student, no customer will know any of us who's working in the company. They will only know the brand that they're interacting with. They will only know Leverage Edu. They will only know like IV100. They will know Uni Valley. And that's the place where we aspire to be. We want to be that company. We want to be a Nike. We want to be a Coca-Cola. We want to be an Apple, right? Touching the same things, the idea is to value people over process as we move forward and scale from here. The value is to, we are building multiple processes. We are building more efficiency in our systems, but to also value innovation over efficiency. And that goes back to having an owner's mindset. That goes back to having accountability. Think about how you can solve something in a better way. Use your brains very actively. Think about how you can innovate different things. And I think that is something that will be rewarded. That is something that will be taken care of as you move forward and do multiple things. With due respect to everybody, we all put efforts. Everybody puts an effort. But efforts are not rewarded. Only results are. Again, last part. Something which is really important and I want to talk about, just a single line, is that, and there's something that some people exhibit more clearly than others, but I would encourage all of you to do that, is I actually ended up writing this down, that so you'll be always be rewarded, I think, in this org at least, for solving problems and have a very solvable attitude towards any problem that comes up versus making small problems look bigger. And we have, like, I think when I say this, everybody will have, come say, bulb chamkega, and they will think of those two people, of some people who actually solve problems and some people who actually make a Hindi proverb, the rai of something and whatnot, right? Who will essentially make a small problem look really, really big. But we are going to be rewarding people who have a very intrinsic attitude towards solving problems, towards being innovative, towards looking at what's the solution versus just harping around what the problem really is. That's it on, that's largely it. Quick recap before I move to the last two parts of this call. We spoke about what's the story, what you've made. We spoke about the vision of transforming lives of a million plus people and their families. We spoke about the mission and the goal, which is different from the vision, which is very quantifiable, that we want to build the largest and the most trusted careers and university admissions company. And how does largest and most trusted translate into our two core company metrics, that of NPS, which measures student happiness. Of course, how many referrals come by it, and our marketing and everything else is a part of it, like Gaurav spoke about. But I think the larger part is minus those referrals, minus those numbers, minus anything else. Is a student really happy that they rate us highly? They rate us a 7, 8, 9, 10. I think that should make us really happy with what we are doing. That means that we are sleeping more peaceful sleep than the previous day. NPS and revenue. And we spoke about where are the three parts of the org moving forward. On that note, we'll just probably call this a close and get back to work, get back to executing in a very fierce fashion. Yes, thank you for your time today, and look forward to doing more cool rocking things with you over the coming year. Leverage it indeed.